Transiting Cities is a competition which has emerged out of a body of research which we've been undertaking in OUTr for over 5 years now.
We're asking for a range of stakeholders and practitioners from around the world, but also in Latrobe, to speculate on the low carbon future for that region.
In Latrobe Valley, we might transform it from being sort of dominated by the coal industry to something that might actually allow it to be much more resilient to economic and political change.
I think the problem with understanding transiting cities and therefore designing and thinking about them in the future is understanding that all parts relate to each other. And not all of these parts are static or conventionally understood. And so how do we relate these parts to each other? How do we understand them and how do we work with them through this discipline of design?
In terms of Australian cities, as transiting cities, as growing cities, I think it's about, as always, it's about the nexus between sustainability and livability.
My understanding of a transiting city in this context is really one that's decided it needs to change and goes through a transition process, probably with some aims and objectives about how it wants to come out at the other end, and a lot of community engagement about that.
Basically, if you understand what is the concept of design, is making sense of things. So actually technology and design are intimately related in order to innovate. Design provides meanings, provide this making sense of things to the technology.
Experimentation, creativity, all these tools that we give our designers, we need to be able to then come back and say, hey, use the whole palette. Let's really do something exciting.
I think the priority for designing the transiting city is about understanding the city to be a dynamic landscape in a constant state of flux.
A priority is really community engagement, government engagement, council engagement, so that the design takes a lot of points of view.
That marrying of the vision, collective vision, individual visions, and people having the skills to come up with real concepts and then details is so important to have that right across the board, I think.
So we have the option now to either grow our cities to become mega cities, at which point we can expect the livability to plummet. Alternatively, we can look at the cities breaking off and becoming rather mega city regions or polycentric regions of urbanism, at which point maybe we can maintain our livability and they might become more sustainable and be able to accommodate more people.
Anyone who's flown over Canberra or flown over Melbourne sees immediately the problem. In some sense, you ought to be able to pick up the suburbs that spread out like a growth on skin, fold them over, make them denser.
Latrobe Valley is kind of a little bit like Victoria's equivalent of Christchurch. It is the place where change is happening the fastest.
Increasingly, and at a local level in the Latrobe Valley, it's that history of having transition done to them that they have become much more involved, proactive, and energized, if you like, to manage that transition much differently and at a much more local level.
We need to have a far more diversified economy and an economy that can still be based on brown coal into the future, but to do so in a responsible and sustainable way.
The future of the power industry and the brown coal sector is somewhat clouded, and therefore the urgency in this case is to develop, I think, a vision of the future.
We're at the horizon. We can see where we're going. And we haven't reached that point yet, but I'm confident we can reach that in 6 to 8 years' time.
The possibility of having a great amount of international attention focused on the Latrobe Valley because of the expected pace of the transition is something we will become excited about. So we're really looking forward to this competition.